Warning, these countdowns are based on Cloud8745's personal opinions, and you need to understand that everyone has their own opinions. If you would like to, make your own countdown as a response to this video, and I shall watch it as well. Enjoy the countdown. At number 10, Metro 2033 for PC. I really like the Metro games, I've always liked them, and it's cool that there's a new one coming out. What was it called, like Metro Exodus or something? But this is Metro 2033, the original version, not the Redux. I never played the Redux for any of the two games that are currently out, so I don't know. I mean, I've heard they're better, but since I've only played, you know, the non-Redux versions, yeah, I just like these. It's a pretty hard game, well, the not-Redux version. I've heard the Redux version was definitely made easier and quote-unquote more casual, kind of like the second game was to begin with, but... Anyways, it's an interesting FPS, and it's different than your standard everything's an American FPS, because there's too many of those. I mean, there really are. Most of them are bad. Anyways, if you haven't played the Metro series, I'd recommend you attempt to play it. It's great. At number 9, Alan Wake for the Xbox 360. There was a time when there was just no good horror games that came out, and Silent Hill was going down the shitter, and I just wanted Alan Wake to come out, because I always remember reading about it, and then one day, it finally came out. And I liked it. It was definitely different, you know, instead of guns and stuff, you have a flashlight, and you fight, well, I mean, okay, you do fight with guns still, but... You fight with a gun, flare guns, etc. like that, and use the power of light to defeat the darkness. I know that sounds a lot like Kingdom Hearts, but that's not the point. Inspired by Stephen King stuff and etc., Alan Wake is very good. Got a bunch of good story DLC, and it's got a standalone game that's pretty cool too. Too bad we're never probably going to get the sequel to Alan Wake, because they're too busy making other games that are bad. What? I miss Alan Wake. At number 8, God of War 3 for the PlayStation 3. This was, well, my final God of War game, and what I consider to be the best God of War game to ever come out. Kratos literally is against all the gods this time. This is the end of the show, the series finale. Well, you know, except they're making a new one, but that's more so Norse mythology, but yeah. So, you know... Your standard thing, Kratos is angry, and he's going to literally kill everything. It's a little ridiculous, and really, I feel like the series really should have just ended here. But I guess they really wanted to milk that God of War. I mean, I'm pretty sure the new one's going to be good. I mean, I did pre-order it, so it's not like I'm trying to be mean to it, you know. So, yeah, I don't know. I just really like God of War 3, and it's my favorite God of War game. Better than 1 and 2, by long shot. At number 7, Deadly Premonition for the Xbox 360. Not the director's cut, that just says that because I have the PC version out, which is a director's cut, but I initially played this on the Xbox 360. It's a very quirky game, very weird, you know, by Swery, created by Swery, who also made the unfinished game, what was it, D4? Anyways... Deadly Premonition is definitely a game that it takes a very specific person to love it, because you'll either love it or you'll hate it. It definitely doesn't control that great at times. It has a good story, though. Has a lot of interesting, quirky, strange, etc. characters, and it's a weird, weird game. And it was initially introduced to me by J-Man, who told me that if I didn't like the game, he would stop talking to me forever. Such a great friend. I'm not being sarcastic, though. I'm glad he recommended me to play it, because I love the game so much. At number 6, Sin and Punishment 2, or, you know, Sin and Punishment Star Successor for the Wii. I was going to say shmup. I mean, it really is kind of a shmup, so whatever. So... It's your standard, quote-unquote, shoots them up, dodging shit. It's definitely got a lot of crazy boss battles. Final boss is insane, especially if you're on the higher difficulties. It's interesting. I don't know. You can shoot your bullets, you can do your charge shot, you can do dodge rolls. You also got melee attacks for things if they're too close. Yeah, but this game really, 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 like, shines its great light during its boss battles. And it's definitely one of the best Wii games to ever come out. Yeah, and for those who never played the original one, well, that's because, you know, it's on the N64, and isn't it Japanese only, I think? Whatever. But yeah, great game if you have a Wii, and yeah.
At number 5.
Ace Attorney, Miles Edgeworth, Investigations for the Nintendo DS. Yep, this is the branch-off series of the Ace Attorney series, where we play as Miles Edgeworth, the prosecutor extraordinaire. This ain't no defense attorney game. This is all about the investigations that happen after murders, and you know, where we're trying to find out who done did it and get them in court. So obviously, you know, we could quote-unquote prosecute them. Now, the prosecuting part doesn't happen in the game, but it doesn't have to. The story for these games are phenomenal. There are two of them, one of them that never came out in America, but both of them are connected, and a great story. It's one of my favorite Ace Attorney games. Well, keep calling it Ace Attorney. But yeah, it's great. If you love the Phoenix Wright series, I recommend you give this and possibly the other one a try. But how would you give the other one a try? I don't know. Maybe there was a fan translation or something.
At number 4.
Monster Hunter Try for the Wii. Or Monster Hunter 3 Try. It's a title. This is what I call for some people the New Age baby's first Monster Hunter. Now, this was not my first Monster Hunter. And it's definitely one of the easier Monster Hunters. It's easier to control with the classic controller. And it introduced something different. Swimming. Which, I'll admit, was not that great. The underwater is, like, stuff and segments are a bit finicky and not my favorite, but you do eventually get used to it. And then you get to fight the God of the Seas, the final boss, in an interesting little fight. It mostly takes place at the end of it, but like most big bosses, they don't attack for a while. I don't know, but you know, I love Monster Hunter games, so of course you probably have, obviously, you know, seen another Monster Hunter game on the countdown. You shouldn't be surprised by now, just accept it. It's great.
At number 3.
Mass Effect 2 on the PC. My favorite Mass Effect game, you know, even though in the series your choices hardly ever really mattered, but whatever. Mass Effect 2 is when they decided to go a different approach. Yeah, Mass Effect 1 was a lot more, like, RPG-feely, while this one was more action-oriented. It's more of a cover-based shooter, and, you know, you still play as Shepard, whatever you name him. And you don't got your infinite ammo thermal clips anymore, or whatever it was. But, yeah. I don't know. Mass Effect 2 has a fantastic story, great characters that will all be ruined in the next game, so don't worry too much. Sorry. It's 2018 and I still will not get over it. But yeah, no, I had a ton of fun. I remember when Mass Effect 2 first came out, I just played it for so long.
At number 2.
Bayonetta for the PS3. Now, Bayonetta's been released for multiple systems like the Wii U, the Switch, and etc. And this is just, I first played it on the PS3. This, whatever you want to call, hack and slash, etc., was made by Platinum, of course, and I really like it. I actually prefer Bayonetta over Devil May Cry, which might surprise some people. They'll be like, what? But yeah, it's my opinion, but so it doesn't really matter. And yeah, that's about it. Bayonetta is just a really fun game. I enjoy it. I'm looking forward to the third game. It's ass-tastic. I mean, it's Bayonetta-tastic. Yeah, but I first played it on the PS3. I unlocked everything. Normally, she'd be wearing her outfit where she, you know, it's made out of hair and uses her hair demons and all that crazy shit. But I don't know, just the action, the weapons, the fighting, etc. I just really like it. So, yeah. What else? I don't know. It's got some really fun bosses, though, I'll say that much. And a pretty crazy final boss, but all of them are.
And now, before number 1, let's go over a recap.
Number 10, Metro 2033 on PC. And number 9, Alan Wake on the Xbox 360. Number 8, God of War 3 for the PS3. And number 7, Deadly Premonition for the Xbox 360. Number 6, Sin and Punishment 2 for the Wii. Number 5, Catcoon Kenji, Miles Edgeworth for the DS. And number 4, Monster Hunter Tri for the Wii. And number 3, Mass Effect 2 for PC. And at number 2, Bayonetta 1 for the PS3.
And finally, at number 1,
Mario Galaxy 2! Super Mario Galaxy 2 for the Wii! The second and final of the Galaxy games, and my favorite of the Galaxy games, actually. It's just, some people might just look at it and see more of the same. But when I look at it, when I played it, I don't know. I just think this game was overall better. I 100%ed it, at least from my knowledge I did. I had as much fun as I could have with it. And I just like this one over Mario Galaxy 1 a lot, you know. And then we play as Luigi, because, heck yes, a Luigi, the best brother. But, you know, everyone knows that. You know, just saying. But yeah, Galaxy 2 still got that weird, orientation of stuff, how you, see the camera, but you'll get used to it. Fun stages, fun boss battles, good music, it's got everything. It's a great Mario game, it's a great Luigi game. So, yeah. And then we, of course, move on to a better Mario game. Which one is that? I don't know. Let's play later, though. Anyways, make your own countdown in response to this video so I can see your own personal opinions. Hope you guys have been enjoying. I know I have. I say that every time, almost. But yeah, Mario Galaxy 2, great game. I know a lot of people want Mario Galaxy 3, but I kind of want them to just keep going with new stuff. Maybe Odyssey again. I don't know. Anyways, that is all, and I'll see you guys in 2011.